Hello friends, I am Sampada Kulkarni, welcomes you in my channel Tech Talks. In this video lecture series from the Heap Sort, now this is time to explain what is Heap Sort, what are the steps to perform the sorting on the given heap data structure, and I am going to explain it with the help of solved example. Now let's start with the basics or the introduction to heap sort. Mainly, what are heaps? Heaps are nothing but the data values which are collected together. To store the heaps, we are going to use an array. Along with array, we are going to make use of tree data structures always. Here I would like to explain you that these are the basic things, that is, this is the comparison based sorting technique, and it uses a binary heap data structure and all. It is similar to selection sort. All these things are okay, but now when I am going to perform the heap sorting, I can make use of arrays as well as trees to perform the heap sorting. So what do you mean by array? What do you mean by trees? For that I am providing you a shortcut link over here. You can go through that if you don't know about the arrays and trees and basically complete binary tree. Then you can come return back or resume this video for the further instructions. Heap sort works visualizing the elements of the array as a special kind of complete binary tree. And that complete binary tree is called as heap. But why the special kind? I have said, because a speciality between that heap is nothing but either that heap is max heap tree or a min heap tree. So what is that speciality? Speciality is that in the max heap tree, always the parent node is greater than its children node, and in min heap tree, always the parent node is minimum or lesser than its children node. This is the speciality. If this special property is followed by a complete binary tree, then we can say that this is the max heap tree or a min heap tree respectively. And these heap trees we are going to use to perform the sorting technique. Now let's start with the steps which are required for the sorting using heap sort. So very first thing, if we are having a max heap tree, if the heap satisfies the max heap property, that means that, or it means that the largest element is stored at the root position. What I can do, this largest element, as I want to perform a sorting, this is the comparison based sorting, I will remove this largest element, that is a root element, and put at the end of the array. After putting at the end of the array, that is the last element of my tree, the last element at which position I am putting that element or a root element, that I am going to replace it with the root position. So ultimately I am swapping the root element and the last element of my array. After performing the swap operation or swap function, it indicates that the largest element is present at the last position of my array and the last position element is present at the root position. Now after swapping, we need to perform the reducing the size of the heap or the array by 1. And after that, once you are going to reduce the size by 1, whatever is now current root element, we can't say that after performing the swapping, the tree remains max heap tree. If it is not, we need to perform the heapify function again to convert that complete binary tree into the max heap tree, and after that we need to again remove the root element, because after performing heapify, your root is the maximum element or the highest element from your rest of array. So I am going to repeat this process repeatedly, that is, if my tree is max heap tree, remove the root node, as the root node is the highest element, put at the last position, and the last element I need to replace it with the root node. If the tree is not satisfying the max heap property, heapify it. Again, after heapifying, the highest element is going to become a root node. Again, perform the remove operation, replace it with the end of the least, and before moving to the next step, do not forget to reduce the size of heap by 1. Because after removing one by one the root node, you will get the least in a sorted format. How to perform this process repeatedly, I am going to explain it with the help of example. Now let's see, I am having max heap tree with me. How to construct this max heap tree, I have already explained in the previous video from this series. If you want to know about how to perform this, I am flashing a shortcut link over here. You can go through that. Now let's consider I am having this list with me in the form of max heap. You can see that the root node is 12, which is the highest element from this list. Which one is the last element, which is present at the 5th position? I am going to replace it with 12 with 9 and 9 with 12. After swapping, my tree will look like this. After that, I am going to reduce my least by 1. I am going to consider only 0 to 4 values. In this way, I am going to detach this, the highest element, from my array, and I am putting that at the position, last position of my array. Now this only rest of the tree is my the next step. Here you can see that after detaching the element, 9 is going to become a root node. As my 9 is a root node, is this tree satisfies the max heap property? You can see that no, this tree is not satisfying the max heap property, or this tree is not a max heap tree. So apply heapify function to make this tree as a max heap tree. So 9, its child node is 6, and another child node is 10. From these siblings, I am going to select the highest one, that is 10, and that I am going to replace it with the root node. So 9 and 10 I am going to replace with their position. 10 is at position 0 and 9 is at position 2, and now 10 is my root node. Now let's see whether this tree is a max heap tree. Yes, this is the max heap tree. Now as I am getting this max heap tree, it indicates that the root node is the highest value node from my tree. So now I will replace it with the last element of my heap or my array. The last element is now, the element is 1 at position 4. I am going to replace 10 with 1, 1 with 10. And what I need to do? I need to reduce the array size by 1. So I have reduced the array size by 1. Now my array is having only 4 elements, that is 0, 1, 2 and 3. And I am detaching 10 from my tree. Now my tree is having only the 4 elements where the root node is 1. Now let's see, if the root node is 1, whether this tree is satisfying the max heap property. No, this tree is not satisfying a max heap property, as its both the children are greater than the root node. So to satisfy the property of max heap, we need to apply the heapify function, in which I will identify the highest node from these two siblings, which is nothing but 9. 9 is going to replace with 1. 9 is present at position 2. 1 is present at position 0. After replacing, now my root node is 9. Now this is the tree which is max heap tree, and now it's ready to perform the next step of sorting, that is detaching the root node. Before detaching, replace the root node with the last node of my array or the max heap, and then detach a root node. So 9 is replaced with 5, 5 is replaced with 9. Here you can see that 9 is present at 0 position, 5 is present at 3rd position, and after replacing them, they will look like this. That is, 9 it has position 3, and reduce the size by 1 and remove the element from the max heap. After that, here again you can see that this tree is not satisfying the max heap property. What we need to do? We need to apply the heapify function, where 5 and 6 are going to swap with each other. After swapping, 6 is going to become a root node. As the 6 is a root node, is the maximum value from the max heap tree. I am going to replace it with the last element of my array. Now only 3 elements are there in my array which we are going to consider. Simultaneously you can see that the 1 by 1, when you are reducing the least by 1 or detaching the element, last element from the array which is replaced with the root node, your array is increasing from the upper boundary by 1 to the left hand side, and all the elements are in the sorted format. After replacing 6 with 1, 1 with 6, here again we are reducing the size by 1 and the sorted elements are in the sorted list. And in this way, only the 2 elements are remaining in my list now. They are 1 and 5. Now let's see whether it is satisfying the max heap property. No, to satisfy the max heap property, replace the elements. Now only 2 elements are there. No comparison is required with the sibling. After replacing, let's see whether this tree is heapified or not, or a max heap or not. Yes, it is a max heap. After getting a max heap, I need to replace the root node, which is the highest node, with the last element of my array. So again I will replace 5 with 1, 1 with 5, it will look like this. After replacing it, I am going to detach 5 from the list and I am going to reduce the list by 1. After detaching 5, only a single element is present in my array and it will look like this. If the single element is there, no any child node is present, it means that no comparison is required. I am going to include that in my sorted list. So here you can see that my list is in the sorted format, and in this way I can perform the sorting with the help of max heap in this heap sorting. Thank you dear friends, I hope you are understanding the concept of heap sorting with the help of max heap tree and the heapify process. Please do not forget to give the comment. If you like the content and the video, please like my video, subscribe my channel Tech Talks, share it with your friends, keep the bell ringing, because ringing bell will give you the notification about my channel, about new videos. Here I am providing you the shortcut link for the subscription of my channel. Please subscribe my channel. Along with this, I am providing you the shortcut link for a next video from this Heap Sort lecture series. Thank you.